we came down here, we bought 300 hectares of rundown sheep farm. We wanted a place that we could irrigate, and we found it. We were running sheep and beef and some crop. We weren't making any money, so we got an equity partner in, and we've converted to dairying, and we're milking just under 2,000 cows. It's going quite well.
Sarah and John Wright, we have four adult children, ages 26 to 21, three daughters and a son, none of whom are farming at the moment. And we've lived in Fairlie almost 14 years, beginning of April, it'll be 14 years. And it's a lot different, as John will describe, to what it is now.
We are limited the amount of water we've got. That's the reason we went to variable rate irrigation, so we can use the water a lot more efficiently than what we have been. We've got various soil types on the farm, and there's no point putting water on the heavy soils when they didn't need it, and there's also no point in putting a lot of water on the light soils. So with the variable rate irrigation, we're using our water a lot more efficiently and not watering areas that we shouldn't be watering. And it's meant that we can irrigate another 70 or 80 hectares of the farmland that we didn't have water for. So we're basically irrigating the whole farm now with 155 litres a second. We started irrigating with two rotorainers. They've got some disadvantages. One is that we can't vary the rate of the amount of water they put on, and you know, we are putting on too much water. This year we've actually sped them up and shift them twice a day, which actually creates a lot more labour than normally once a day, putting on 50 mils. But now we're putting on 25 mils, which is twice as much as what the pivots put on. But we just can't get around quick enough. You can't shift them all the time. And also their watering pattern is not nearly as effective as a pivot. And the outside actually gets a bit more water than the inside.
Hi, I'm Sarah Wilson from Precision Irrigation. We're the company that developed, designed and manufactured the Precision VRI variable rate irrigation system. So Precision VRI is an add-on to a centre pivot or a linear move irrigator. It enables you to individually control every sprinkler along the length of an irrigator. That provides unlimited flexibility of the areas that you are able to control your application depths to. The add-on can be added to a new pivot or new irrigator on purchase, or retrofitted to an existing irrigator. The hardware involved in the system, we have a main controller which is on the centre of a pivot or one end of a linear move. This is the brains. This is a touch panel PC. It sends out wireless signals to wireless nodes which run along the length of the irrigator. There's a wireless node every four sprinklers. On the end node, there is a GPS mounted. This allows the main controller to know where the pivot is at any point in time, and therefore control the sprinklers accordingly. So at this point in time, as the irrigator is going over the drain, the sprinklers will be turning off as they go over the top of the drain to avoid putting any water into that drain.
This here is a wet area that the variable rate doesn't water. You can see it's still quite wet, but it never gets water. It sort of follows down a wee bit of a gully, wee spring. So when the irrigator gets here, it just dry, just stops it. And it's a lot drier here than just back there. And with the tracks, they're not getting watered, therefore there's repairs and maintenance on them is a lot less. We live on the banks in the Opahi River, and we're very mindful not to overwater. As soon as we overwater, we're putting nutrients into the river. This is the EM map that Landcare did for us. It's got the three pivots we got on here. This is the one that goes all the way around. It's got three different soil types. A lighter soil, medium soil, and some heavier soils. This one here has got four soil types, light stony soil. There's the red, dark red areas, the orangey areas, the medium soil. This one here that's got a bit of green through it, it's quite a heavy soil. And this one that's really green is, it's a light soil, but it's got a hard pan underneath so the water sits on top. So if I click on this paddock here, it's got change oil polygons name number two, which is a soil type zone 2, 5 mils. So just to change it, all we do is plug in and say we want to put 15 mils on that paddock. We just plug in 15 for there and press OK, and it should come up. See, that's paddock getting 15 mils. You got over here, you've got two paddocks getting nothing. They've just been sprayed out. They've just been direct drilled actually in fescue. Say for instance the cows are coming into this paddock tonight, and we know it's a paddock that can get a bit wet, we don't want any more water on it and the irrigator's going over, we can just give it no water, so that paddock won't get any irrigation as the pivot goes over. This is one of our Aquafix tubes, it's in the ground heading out that way. One's 200 mils below the ground, and the other one's 500 mils.
And they measure the moisture in the soil.
Sends back the pulse to a wee box in here, and then it's transmitted back through the wireless to the house. I can see it from the house. One of the websites I use is the Boorman site, which it's got all the moisture probes linked to it. Also, all our irrigation pumps are on telemetry, so I can tell just by looking on the website, you know, what the pumps are using. This graph here is our maximum take, 155 litres a second. You can see we were just over it for a wee period there, just a wee bit. Now we've dropped it back. Here we're not using quite as much as we should be. Maybe we've got a pump that's turned off. And you see, further down, you got every pump. This is one that can use 25 litres a second. You can see we're just sitting on that line quite nicely. You can see here, that's when the irrigation's gone over the moisture probes. We're putting on about 5 mils. This moisture probe is on the heavier soil. And we're holding a pretty straight line, so we're not going backwards. This zone here, it's on a lighter soil, and you can see we're actually losing ground. So we're using more water than what we can put on. That's why it's handy to know when it's going to rain. We don't want to get too much lower than that, but it's been pretty hot lately, so we're just losing ground. We just can't keep up.
I had a hissy fit 2 years ago and said, right, this is ridiculous. I need a computer to write up minutes and things. So I had to buy a laptop. He is on the computer all the time when he's inside. He was computer illiterate. He didn't know what a flash stick was.
with technology, we've got to get a pretty good payback before we put it in. And with the variable rate, I think it was 30-40% return on investment, which is pretty good. It's money in the bank. We haven't put in some of the technology in the dairy shed yet, ProTrack and bits and pieces like that. It's on the radar, we will put it in, but we're a lot better return with the irrigation and we were short of water. So that's why we wanted to get the irrigation system right first. You can still milk cows without ProTrack. You can't grow grass without decent irrigation.